Hi, and welcome to Studio SN. My name is Sarah Newman, and today we're combining alcohol inks and Eclectica stamps. This card design features a quick and easy way to add color to your cards and create an instant background for stamped images. And you can see this border that goes across the center of my card. Well, this is alcohol ink. And if you can also see some of the green and pale pink spatters back here on the background, that is alcohol ink as well. So we're going to be doing some brayering as well as some spattering with our alcohol inks. Such fun and so easy to do to create a background ready for your stamping. So I'm going to bring in my white cardstock, and this is a plain matte cardstock. You can also use glossy cardstock, and that's going to give you a slightly different effect. But for this one, I'm using a matte cardstock. And then, of course, I also need my alcohol inks. And this is the CRH. This is from Spectrum Noir. And this is what you would use to refill your Spectrum Noir alcohol ink pens. But, of course, they work beautifully for backgrounds as well. So I have CRH for my border going across here. I also want to have some rubbing alcohol. And this is one that I picked up in a spray bottle. You can get this at your local pharmacy or drugstore. And then I also want to have my brayer on hand. And this is just a little rubber brayer, about 2.5 inches wide. So working onto my craft sheet, I'm going to use the stopper bottle here. You'll see it has a nice little applicator here. And I'm just going to put a little bit of the CRA onto my craft sheet and then spritz it with the rubbing alcohol. And that just gets it a little bit more diluted and easier to brayer. It's not quite such a strong color either. So I'm just going to brayer this across my background. And then what I'm going to do is clean this off my craft sheet with a baby wipe. And then you can always come back and really give your craft sheet and your brayer as well a thorough clean with that rubbing alcohol. Now I have this going across the center of my cardstock, and I want to come in and add a little bit more of that spattered effect. So this is my brayering, and here comes my spattering. This is PP1. It's this really pretty, very subtle pink. And what I'm going to do is just hold the applicator parallel to my cardstock and hit it with my other hand. And that's going to give me the spattered effect. So you don't need to do it a whole lot. You don't need to fill the barrel of this, because just having a little bit on the end is going to do just fine. So spatter that with the really pale pink, and then I'm going to come in with LG3, really pretty pale green. And again, same technique, I'm just going to be hitting my hand with my other hand, or hitting the bottle with my other hand, and tapping some of this color on. This is a good way to use your craft sheet as well, because this will, it does kind of go beyond your paper, so this will be an easy cleanup as well. So once I have my spattering on here, then I can go ahead and stamp, because this is actually dry. So I'm ready to stamp, and I'm going to bring in my Vintage Lady on here. Now this is from the Eclectica stamp set, and this is the ESN 16, and I'm going to use this really pretty Vintage Lady. Actually, I found her on a vintage French fashion newspaper from the turn of the century, and so I'm really glad that she was able to be turned into a stamp so nicely so that we can all use her. And I wanted to use a really nice crisp black, so I'm using the Onyx Black. This is VersaFine, and I wanted something quite crisp so that it would be a nice contrast to the alcohol ink background. So I'm inking her up. And then I'm just going to stamp her down. Now, when I do this, I want to play with the positioning, because I don't really want to have a green blob right in the middle of her face. So I want to sort of consider the positioning on there before I stamp her down. And then lift, and you can see what a nice crisp image that is. Now, if you take a look again at my original card, I have some script going around here on the sides. And I didn't want it to be quite as stark as that black. So rather than stamping that with the black, I'm using the Stazon in Dove Gray. And again, I'm going to take another one of the images from that Eclectica stamp set. And this is a bit of script. This is from an old letter. Again, thrift store find. And I want to do this one over here on the side. And I'm not pressing quite as hard, but you can see it adds a little bit on top of that brayered background, but it's not competing with the dark black of my Vintage Lady. If you watch Downton Abbey, she always makes me think of Lady Mary. I like this one. So then I'm going to come back in and stamp the same script, just going the opposite direction on the other side there as well. So then I've got almost all of my background done. What I've done on here, and I'll show this to you as well, is I used a little postmark up here, top and bottom, so I have some nice balance, and then also this postmark going across here. The postmark has been stamped in black just because I wanted it to be a little bit darker to provide a little bit more of an anchor on there. But you'll notice on here, I have managed to avoid some of the green blobs on her face. But then what I've done, after I've completed my background and it's all dry and ready to go, quick and easy, I've simply edged around the outside with an embossing ink pad and then embossed with gold metallic embossing powder before matting this up onto white cardstock. I mounted it again up onto blue and then added some green just going across the center of my card. And having that green only going in the center really does echo the border going across the center of my background as well. And then I've just got some gold thread and a little bit of gold silk ribbon here up in the corner. Quick and easy and done in probably about half an hour. So it's a great technique to have on hand when you need to make a card quickly. So this is how you can use alcohol inks with Eclectica stamps to create a pretty collage background for your handmade cards. I hope you enjoyed today's show. For more ideas and inspiration, please stop by my website at sarahnewman.com. If you enjoyed today's video, I invite you to subscribe to Studio SN on YouTube, and I'll keep you updated with a new video every Wednesday. Thank you for joining me on Studio SN, and I will see you again next time.